What Maddie's doing right now is just broad forking the bed. This is the tractor on the farm. Maddie is the tractor at the moment.
I'm the tractor. I love being the tractor.
Yeah.
We're the tractors, this is the soil, that's the deal, you know? What's up, everybody? I'm Maddie Matheson.
I'm Keenan McVeigh. I'm the farm manager here.
Over the next couple episodes, we're gonna kind of show you what we do here at Blue Goose Farm.
Yeah, we're gonna show you guys around. It's a small farm project started by Maddie and myself about 2 years ago, and it's kind of hitting its stride right now. We're gonna show you guys things we've learned, things that went right, things that went wrong.
A lot of wrongs.
A lot of wrong before you get it right. You know, this has been a place for us to kind of learn how to be a steward to a small patch of land, grow really good food, take care of people, and take care of each other.
Like that. Blue Goose, we're here to take care of each other. The real story of why we started Blue Goose was we were shooting my second cookbook here. Working with Keenan is very inspiring on a lot of different levels. So if you don't know Keenan, Keenan's my, he's like my favorite chef in the city. Keenan was just kind of like, you got so much like land. And so when we were working together on my cookbook, the inspiration for just farming, gardening, kind of grew from there. This is the original plot. This is the little goose, about 3,500 square feet, 25 11-foot beds.
But this is basically the small plot that we've used to kind of teach ourselves a lot of different techniques, a lot of different ways to grow food. Every bed was a different crop, just to kind of learn the ins and outs of each cultivar as best as we could before we implement on a large scale. For anybody looking to start a farm or do anything on a large scale, I would highly recommend starting as small as you can.
Crawl, walk, run.
Yeah, that's kind of the motto that we followed. This was the crawl.
Yeah.
It was a pretty fast crawl.
This was a big crawl. It's a big crawl going from zero to this.
Yes.
You don't have to have a giant garden. If you had just one raised bed in your yard and like a trellis, you can grow a lot of vegetables.
There's a lot of neat tricks you can do with interplanting and intercropping or relay cropping, which some people do while you're harvesting, you're planting, and just constantly keeping this cycle going. A lot of mistakes that people make is that they'll get a bed like this and plant the whole thing out at the beginning of the spring and then take it all out in midsummer and then their garden is done for the year. But if you just do a little bit of research on cold hardy crops, things that you can start early in the spring, like radishes and greens that do really well, you can get those started early and then start working warmer season crops into it, and then some mid-season crops, and then back into your cold season crops, and just keep it going. What soil wants is for things to be growing in it, not only benefiting you by having more harvest and more food coming in your kitchen, but you're only benefiting your soil too. Living roots in the ground and leaves photosynthesizing is the name of the game. The more you have going on is what you want. So this might be a little bit more of a relatable experiment for people living with small growing spaces if you just have a little patio. Even in this tiny terracotta pot, I have one massive tomato. I've got some lemon gem marigold and some butter lettuce interplanted as well. Interplanting something like a marigold, this is gonna bring in pollinators. So when the tomato starts putting out more flowers as it gets taller, pollinators are gonna be interested in these marigold flowers and then move on to the tomato. The lettuce is really just to kind of keep the soil covered. It's keeping weed pressure out and living roots in the ground, which is great. Every time too, we harvest something at the farm, we never twist them out and clean the roots off after. We always cut at the base and leave the living roots in the soil. We're leaving a little bit of food for the microorganisms to munch on.
This plot right here could feed 30 people all year round.
Eventually too, we want the big garden, the big goose as we call it, to kind of be almost a mirror reflection of what this little garden is.
One of the biggest inspirations in gardening is compost. If you have good vegetables, you have good compost. One of the biggest things when we started was we needed to be able to compost and create something that is gonna be like almost like a zero waste situation. And this gives back. It's just a full circle.
Nature kind of has this natural law of return where when you take something, you know, you need to put something back. And that happens naturally in the woods through leaves falling, decomposing on top of the soil, feeding the organisms. So we're kind of doing that with the garden as well. We created a 4-bay composting system. So anything in the garden, trim, scraps, things that go to seed too early. You can see some big pak choys here that bolted too quick. We always start in the second bay. We build this up. And this is done now. We're just gonna let it cook for about 4 to 6 weeks. Once this was filled, we started filling this one up, which filled very quickly. And then the second bay goes into the third bay. We aerate it by adding air and incorporating that oxygen. And then third base goes into the fourth, and then it finishes there. So this is our finished compost from year one. As you can tell, it's not super fine, but we like that for dressing our beds. We can still sift a little bit of it and add that to our seeding mix as well, which we do from time to time.
From seed to vegetable to, you know, waste to compost back to the soil, that circle of life, that's the goal. That's like, that is the win. Now we're gonna go into the big plot, harvest some lettuce, turn over a bed, and we'll see what's up.
Cool, so we're just removing the last of these butter lettuces. We gotta harvest them pretty fast just because it's getting a little hot out right now, and lettuce doesn't really like being left out in the heat.
So this is what like Keenan was talking about, how we leave the roots of the lettuce. This will eat itself and turn into better soil.
Just trying to wrap our head around the sheer scale of it has been the biggest challenge. And very small crew here too, with a limited amount
very
of hands.
Very small crew?
Yeah.
Keenan's the crew.
So my last garden before this was just a small little patio in a condo in Toronto. And my wife and I just grew some flowers and some herbs and stuff. So yeah, it's a little bit of a level up. Like we said, it's just a matter of taking your time, learning from mistakes. There's mistakes happening all the time. You know, we've probably just made a mistake in the last 15 seconds here, and we'll learn about it.
Look at this head of lettuce. Like this head of lettuce, you could easily have a beautiful salad for 10 people.
I'll be right back. I gotta make sure these lettuces get into the fridge or they're...
There we go. So the lettuces come out, we cut them from the root. We have to get them in the fridge, naturally cool them down as quick as possible. Chilling them gives them a little more shelf life. So the biggest thing this season was to build a walk-in cooler out here. In here is all gonna be a wash station where we pick the vegetables, bring them in here. So this will be a walk-in cooler.
In the wintertime when we start doing our first seedings, like onions and some early brassicas, like really cold hardy, frost hardy vegetables, we're gonna set up our grow lights and our racks in here just to get an early jump on the season.
So then this will be a tool shed on this side. Put like a little wood burning stove in here, a little zone. We're gonna have a little toilet there and a little outdoor shower. Cool your beans down. Literally as these episodes kind of continue, you're literally gonna see everything grow. You're seeing this from the ground floor.
So we just pulled out the last of the butter lettuces in this bed, and what Maddie's doing right now is just broad forking the bed, slightly loosening the soil. As you can see, he's not inverting or flipping the layers, so he's not really disrupting the biology and the microorganisms that are underneath. Just loosen it a little bit so we can help set the roots down on the next crop a little bit more easily. This is the tractor on the farm. Maddie is the tractor at the moment.
I'm the tractor. I love being the tractor.
Yeah.
I'm the tractor here at Blue Goose. We don't like to use gasoline. We're the tractors. This is the soil. That's the deal, you know?
If we can use these tools and our bones and our muscles, you know, the more you use hand tools, I find you're staring at the ground a lot more and you learn a lot. You know, I'm able to see a weed here and there. I can check on something if it's not looking right. Stick my fingers in the soil, see if it needs any water. But you really bring yourself down to the level of the vegetables and you learn quite a bit more. So this is just a little bit of pelleted chicken manure. It's a 5-3-2 NPK scale. So NPK being nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. And there's also a little bit of glacial rock dust in this, which helps boost the biology in the soil.
We'll use the tilther to go over it, and it just lightly fluffs the compost with the old bed. Low tech, low fi.
So we just do two passes, and then we take our bed rake and we just flatten it out one last time. We're gonna be seeding some Japanese turnips into here. I mean, it's a pretty incredible act of faith to be putting something into the ground and hoping that it's gonna feed you. And it's an incredible experience to just be able to look at a field like the one that I'm looking at right now and to know that every bit of green, it was once a seed that fell through my fingers.
This garden gives way more than vegetables. It's the ultimate humbler. As cliche as it sounds, it grounds you. Like it literally, you come out here and it's just like, and it's just, it's this is what matters. So thanks a lot, everybody. As Blue Goose grows, so will us, so will you. You're never gonna miss anything. We're always gonna be doing this together. We're learning, we're growing, we're harvesting, and everyone gets to watch and enjoy and be inspired. We're inspired, are you inspired?
Very inspired. Yeah, I look forward to showing you guys the progression over the year. There's a lot happening right now, but when you guys come back, there's gonna be a lot of really cool stuff. Late season, summer, tomatoes, peppers, eggplant. Look forward to showing you.
We'll see you soon. Yield great. Yield great.
Let it grow.
Let it grow.
Yield greatly.